Well, hello, my RecTech family. Darren George, DRG Custom Cars, coming back again. Hey, I just wanted to do this really quick little video. This really goes out to everyone out there that's contemplating buying the new hinge that we just released this weekend, or to everyone that has already purchased them. I just want to let you know that after reading some of your comments on Facebook and all that about the hinge, there were some people that really wanted it to be to come with two pins to make it even simpler so that you didn't have to deal with removing the screws every time you wanted to put the high lift hinge on. They wanted it to be a little simpler to where you could just pull the pin and be done. If you remember back several months ago when I launched the prototype for the very first hinge that I was designing, it actually came with two pins at that time. But during the course of the build on this, I thought about trying to build it so that you would never have to worry about losing your factory pin. So that's why I incorporated the factory pin into the build. But after reading your comments and thinking more about it, and it does make sense to just have two pull pins so that you no longer have to have a Phillips screwdriver and you don't have to worry about unbolting it every time you want to go from stock to the Matador or to the rotisserie. So what I've done is these are the ones that were already sold. They were already boxed up the other day and ready to be shipped out. But I just couldn't in good faith send these out to you guys without giving you everything that's going to be coming with the next batch that comes out. So I went back and pulled these and opened them, and I have since installed the second pull pin. So now when you get your Bullseye high lift hinge, it's going to come with two pins. One pin is going to have a D-ring on it, and one pin is going to be bent. The D-ring pin is going to become your permanent Bullseye pin for everything that you're doing. So when you get your hinge, if you want to go to your Bullseye, take out the factory pin and just install the pin with the key ring on it. And that pin will remain in your grill for the rest of your ownership of that grill. So I just wanted to let you guys know that it is coming with that upgrade at no extra charge. It has already been installed into the ones that are going to be shipped out tomorrow. So this applies to everybody that already purchased one. And secondly, I just want to let you know, in one of these boxes, and I do not know which one, there is a special little gift. So when you get yours, make sure you open it and you look at everything, because there is something in one of these boxes that is just my way of giving back to you guys. I love you guys. You guys have been there for me and supported me through this whole thing. I have never forgotten how DRG started. So I just wanted to give back a little something. And also, I just want to let you guys know, when you get this hinge — this was something I thought about the other day and I forgot to put it on the original video — when you're using this hinge and you have your lid attached to the top of it and you're going to be putting on the Matador or you're going to be putting on the rotisserie, don't let your hinge, the lid, fall forward without having your rotisserie in place or the Matador sitting on the Bullseye. The only reason for that is this bracket is extremely heavy duty. When you get it, you're going to see this thing is really built to last you a lifetime. And it is a lot stronger than what the small area on the back of your Bullseye is. So if you prop open the lid and you go to put this on and then you close the lid without your rotisserie being on there, there is a chance you're going to bend the lid on your Bullseye. And I don't want you to damage your Bullseye. So please, if you're going to put the hinge on and you're going to run it with the rotisserie, open the lid, set the rotisserie on your grill, and then change the lid. That way, if the lid happens to slip out of your hand, it's going to come down and land on top of the rotisserie. It's not going to come down from 8 inches in the air and actually buckle your lid. So I really think that goes without saying. Felt that I really needed to say something just to make you mindful of it. Other than that, thank you guys so much for your purchases. Thank you guys so much. I can't wait to see your posts on Facebook. The first group that purchased these, you guys should have these by this weekend. And if not, you're definitely going to have them by the holiday weekend so that you can be cooking some incredible stuff on your bullseye. Also, to let the people know that we're asking about the shelf, I have redesigned the shelf now that I have the CNC table. The new shelf is going to come with some really nice cutouts made in it. It's going to really be incredible. I can't wait till you guys see it. I'm hoping to be able to launch those probably by the end of this week, the first of next week. So other than that, thank you guys so much. God bless you. And as always, smoke like the rest, but roll with the best. I see you, my friends.